so yes, Julia Roland Brannigan. So I'd like to become American actually, because all the big political careers happen in the United States of America. If you're thinking about doing athletic research, I'll jump in more. My aunt is Audrey Hepburn. I've been American and I'd like to be a part of the film business and film industry in the end. Most of the time working for the film industry, I cannot change the routes you are getting the energy from. So I'd like to be American, I'd like to get a citizenship of an American because I think my life in Europe actually is a private holocaust, literally is a private, very unpleasant holocaust. I don't know, maybe I was Anne Frank last, in my last life, and she didn't get the holocaust enough. So I'm still kind of repeating this holocaust way, which I didn't do as Anne Frank last year, last life. I don't know, I'm not a Buddhist, talking about my nations here. But I'd like really to ask people, particularly from Jewish society, from Germany, to stop holocausting them, because it's kind of, I'm kind of fed up with you guys, and it's kind of more than enough. You didn't get anything like that from any artist in the world. So I don't see Gert Richter composing opera, and I also don't see Gert Richter for example, writing screenplays. Like I've written Adopt Me, or I've written Inglourious Basterds, for number two. I don't see, for example, also Leonardo DiCaprio playing piano as good as I do. Obviously, he's an actor, he can just push a button and pretend he's playing piano. As a matter of fact, he's not playing piano as good as I do. I don't see Leonardo DiCaprio composing opera. So Leonardo DiCaprio, you're kind of not as genius as I am. I'm more genius than you. I do understand it's offending you, but you're not the one anymore. And trust me, Leo, if I would know what kind of a cool person you are, I would never write you so much. I would not write one word about you, or for you is my enemy part. I think you're really very disgustingly cruel, neglecting person who is ready to kill every author because they don't have any money in your pocket. I think you're an enormously dangerous, unpleasant, cruel person, and it's proper. How dare you just steal my screenplays and to put me into a private holocaust and then enjoy just my writings and get money from my bank account. I dare you to destroy my life. Actually, who are you? You are just one of the actors, and there are millions of actors in the world, thousands of actors. You're not so important, and trust me, I would never give you a word to play if I knew how bad you are. And next thing goes to, yeah, to Steven Spielberg, who always thinks Jews are always, you know, suffering, and the entire world still have to pay them. I really don't see it like that. I see guys who are really, in German there is a thing, a word, it's called Specknudel. Is that it's not Specknudel. You are so rich and you're so fat in your money, you're really not suffering at all. I'm suffering because you're actually ruling Holocaust right now. So the Jewish society being incredibly cruel to the other nations. Nations, because you somehow really feel that now you're empowered to bring the entire other world to the Holocaust. As a matter of fact, you know, the other people did not Holocaust you. You've been Holocausting with Germans. I'm a Russian. I'm I grew up in Belarus. I'm not even a real German. So I don't understand this intention of making me guilty for something, like as if I was starting a Second World War. And I don't see actually since Spielberg making me guilty for something I didn't say or I didn't do. I mean, there are so many falsificated letters. They are falsificated by my father, because some of them are falsificated by some crazy Germans who have too much money and nothing else to do but write some lies about me and sign me my falsificated signature. As a matter of fact, the last letter which I've really written on my own hands, it's kind of really like 10 years ago maybe, because I'm always writing only, you know, I'm sending SMS, I'm sending some emails, but I'm not such a kind. say, I would be really super happy if Jewish people stop just holocausting everyone and then steal from everyone. I think that the entire nation in the entire world was so cruel to them, and they've been holocausted by the entire world. This is not a truth, this is a lie. You've been holocausted by Germans, by Austrians, but you haven't been holocausted by French or Belgian people. Why are you cruel to them? Why are you cruel actually to Russians? Because Russia was literally drawing in blood, saving Jews. So this is such an injustice here. And I really warn everybody who's a Jewish person, if you're walking into a house of somebody, it doesn't mean that this is your house, this is your real estate, and this is your privacy now, and you're evil, and then you're allowed to get every book from the shelf of a person you're kind of friend with, because a lot of times you're pretending to be friends, and then you're literally ripping the entire life of this person apart. This is not good, this is not right, and you should stop doing this, because people are getting really angry with you, and people are getting poor. There's no need for this Holocaust in the entire world, because you're avenging. I think really the Jewish society should stop avenging and find yourself some kind of other soul food for your life, to be nourishing in your life, because really living out of revenge, it's not good, because this is why the war is existing eternally. This is why eternally is such a very poor, incredibly offended society, because you're kind of always offended, because if there is a rain, probably the person next to you is going to be paying you, because you're a Jewish person, you're suffering from rain. And you know for sure that this rain was sent by this person, and this person is maybe Italian one, and this guy or girl got to be paid. So this is actually the logic of Jews. This is not one, this is not good. This is something you got to work on and got to change, because that is actually the way your society got to this world crisis and world war. And trust me, this way is not paved with golden bricks. So trust to make the roads between you and the entire nations good roads, which is laid out with bricks of goodness and not bricks of rape and being always offending and being always trying to be revenge. So this far I got to say, and yeah, I hope you have a lovely weekend. Goodbye.